Hello students, good morning to all of you. Today I will discuss the topic vector analysis, resolution of vector. In the previous lecture, in the previous video, I have discussed about the addition and subtraction. Now today I will discuss the resolution of vector. Resolution of vector actually the reverse of addition of vector. And you can see the reverse of addition of vector. So here, suppose this is your vector e. We want to resolve into two its parts. How to resolve it? First of all, we draw a plane xy. Now this vector, how to resolve it? First of all, from the head of vector e, draw perpendicular on it, x axis, and perpendicular on the y axis. Suppose take M and take N. Actually, this part 2M is in the direction of x. So its magnitude is equal to AX, and here its magnitude is EY. So here this is Ay and this is also Ay. So if unit vector, if perpendicular unit vector, perpendicular unit vector in the direction of x and y b, I cap and g cap. So I cap can be written as ax vector upon ax, and g cap is equal to ay vector upon ay. So to indicate the direction of this om, so here ax vector is equal to I cap of AX, and AY vector is equal to G cap into AX. So these AX and AY, this AX and AY are the resolved parts. If this vector A makes an angle of theta with X axis, so you can resolve this, resolve it in horizontal and vertical components. So here AX is equal to what? That is A of cos theta. And Ay, that is A of sin theta. Similarly here, if you square and add them, now Ax of whole square, Ay of whole square, that is equal to A square, so A equal to under root of Ax square plus E y square. You can calculate the resultant of this vector. And here, if you add them, because I have said vector A can be resolved in two parts. So here this is the horizontal and this is vertical. So AX plus EY. So vector A can be written as AX vector plus EY vector. If you calculate the resultant of this one, resultant of this one, say A, that is also under root of AX whole square plus AY whole square. So here AX and AY, these are the vector in unit vector form, and these are the AX and AY in horizontal and vertical components. This is very important topic. It will discuss later on in that time, but here you have to remember very clearly here. Now, a small topic here, vector product. Again, I will discuss in the next video, product of vector and scalar. Product of vector and scalar. If you product M and v. This is velocity and this is mass. This is a scalar quantity and this is a vector quantity. The product of this quantity is a vector quantity. Keep remember. So here, if we product, if we try to multiply our scalar quantity with our vector quantity, you get a vector quantity. The vector and vector product, vector and vector product, I will discuss in the next video. Thanks.